Hey there, Nar, what you doing, man? Let me introduce you to my friends. Wait, friends? Where are you guys going? Oh, no. Listen, Nar, I'm sorry, I apologize. Please, can we sort this out like gentlemen? I said I'm sorry, I apologized, please. Okay, just... Look, man. I'm sure we can sort this out. There's no need for violence here. Yo, chill. Hey. Take that. Okay, I got a cue move. I said I'm sorry. But I didn't say what I was sorry for. I'm sorry, Nar. For killing you! Hello, everyone. I'm Petu. If you don't know me, I play Shen. That's about all you need to know. I'm a Shen main from Finland, and I like playing top lane. This season, I wanted to challenge myself even further by learning more champions. And I thought of an interesting concept to do that, where basically I take a champion that I have no or very little previous experience with, and then play that champion for an entire week without playing anything else. So this is kind of a test run for this concept, and for the first video I decided to play Fiora for 7 days. I managed to get a lot of games in, and the progress was definitely noticeable. So why I chose Fiora is because, you know, she's a pretty cool champion, and I think most people find her playstyle attractive, at least top lane players. Because, you know, why wouldn't it be fun to be able to completely destroy the opposing top laner by yourself, and overall this whole playstyle of being like a duelist specializing in 1v1 cases. That sounds pretty like reasonable to me, and I found it interesting. So let's just say that the start was a bit more difficult than I thought. Here in the background you can see some gameplay from my first day of playing Fiora. This game was played versus a Poppy, and I struggled, man, honestly, I struggled. Like, all of these games were played in Diamond 3, Diamond 2 Elo on Europe West, and it was probably a bit above my skill tier with Fiora. But I rose up to the challenge and valiantly tried to improve myself over the course of the entire week. And this video records that progress from me going to a Fiora noob to someone who can pilot the champion in a reasonable manner. As you can see, there were a lot of deaths. Let's just say that was the overwhelming theme of the first day. I died a lot, because I was always like trying to push the champion to its limits, but I didn't know what those limits are. I wasn't mechanically well adept enough to perform the things that I wanted to do. Unlike with a champion like Shen, who I've played for so many hours, I always know how to execute those combinations correctly. But with Fiora, I had no idea what I was doing at first. I just knew that, okay, you gotta hit vitals and it'll be alright, right? You can parry stuff, it should be good. For my runes and basically whole setup during the course of this week, what I did is I played either Grasp of the Undying or Fleet Footwork, depending on what kind of matchup I was in. These runes were comfortable for me. I didn't really like Conqueror per se. I more enjoyed the playstyle of Fleet and Grasp because they were more familiar to me. So I took Grasp versus melee lanes where I know I can fight them, and then I took Fleet Footwork, which was more like a scaling page versus champions who will bully me in the game. And for the build that I did for this entire week, it was basically Gore Drinker into Ravenous Hydra for some Omnivamp and then situational, but I mostly build items like the what is it that gives you like executioner's calling upgrade and then Blade of the Ruined King. So those were my items. Now we can look here actually. This is my first solo kill in this game. Like it looks pretty bad for me. This Poppy was like 5-0 at this point because I had been feeding. And I was feeding. But I managed to catch her off guard. My first day of playing Fiora was kind of like getting dropped into the deep end of the pool. I actually struggled a lot with using her W riposte, or her parry, efficiently. You know, I played versus this Aatrox on my first day, and you know, it didn't go too bad. I was doing fine. It's not really a big deal. It's not like I was like really hard inting it every game, but it was definitely like just knowing how to use that parry or W, and I think a lot of the time I was simply using it too late because I was always like trying to wait for the opponent's best ability, and then I didn't parry soon enough to survive the damage. All right, fast forward to day three of playing Fiora. I met this champion in the top lane called Malphite. You guys ever played versus Malphite? It seemed like a very fair and close 1v1, the Fiora versus Malphite matchup. I was enjoying it a lot, honestly. It felt like both players had massive room for skill expression, and I would have actually liked to play the matchup a bit more. It just felt like the kind of thing that I actually want to experience in the top lane, you know, 1v1 duels that both sides have an equal chance of winning. But for some unknown reason, Malphite just didn't appear in the rest of my games as Fiora. I don't know what caused this. No idea. Anyways, I managed to get this nice outplay 1v1. Let's take a look. We proc all four vitals, then we get another vital proc here, and then ooh, that's an E-flash mechanic. You auto-attack and then flash on the opposite side of the champion so that the game registers the auto-attack coming from that direction and procs the vital. As a side note, we actually managed to win this game after I got that solo kill. I was definitely not the reason why we won that game, and in this game I decided that it was actually time to improve. So we need to improve my Fiora mechanics, and the only way to do that, practice duel and a lot of games. You know what time it is? It's time for a training montage. honing my fear mechanics to absolute perfection, it was time to put them to the test. I came up against my arch nemesis, my main champion, Shen. Now, this is a matchup that I've played from the opposite side so many times, Shen versus Fiora, but never have I played Fiora versus Shen as Fiora, you know? I actually very much enjoyed playing versus Shen, which was surprising, because actually, you can see here, I have a nice escape from this gank by utilizing those vitals well. Look, Shen TP's the bot lane, and this is just something that I learned. Destroying towers as Fiora is so much fun, honestly. Just seeing that Shen TP the bot lane, or ult the bot lane, without having TP up, makes me so happy. Because I got this entire tower for myself, got so many minion waves, and man, it just made me feel good. So, something that I realized while playing Fiora is that I had to adapt my mindset to this new playstyle of being more selfish than before. Because as a Shen main, I've grown to be very selfless and always look like for the greater cause for our team and like sacrifice myself for my team. But now, when I was playing Fiora, I had to be selfish, I had to take farm for myself, I had to keep my TP, I had to take those towers and just farm for myself so that I could get strong. And here, I'm like, when Shen is in bot lane, I'm always taking the enemy jungle camps and just getting really fed. And if we take a look at scoreboard right now, I'm 0-0-1 and I have a 400 gold shutdown, just because I've been farming so well. And at this point, I become extremely strong when I have like 11 CS per minute, and then I've reached my 2-item power spike, and Fiora becomes a lot of fun at this point. As someone who's played primarily tanks like Shen, who don't scale well into the late game, it was definitely refreshing to experience a late game carry as your champion. Now, something that I also learned, which you can see from this clip, is that Draven is a dumbass for thinking that he can kill me right here. No. We actually got Baron after this, and looked like the game was going in our favor, definitely. I started to notice that I was getting much cleaner with my movement. Especially hitting vitals was becoming much easier now. And here you can see a good example of me getting a quick 4 vital ultimate onto Graves for the kill. Now, if I fool you once, shame on me. But if I fool you twice, shame on you, Draven. I baited him once again to get the kill. All jokes aside, I feel like playing Fiora taught me a lot about top lane in general. Because my view as a top laner had been very narrow for the past few years, with mainly sticking to Shen as my comfort pick. And as you can see here, I finished the game with a KD of 6 kills and 2 deaths and 6 assists. And it was definitely a game where I felt like I had a lot of impact. Towards the end of this 7-day grind, on day 6 and day 7, I started to really notice that I had improved immensely as a Fiora player. Not only were my Fiora mechanics better, but I also knew how to win the game as Fiora. What Fiora's objective is in a game, and how to play a selfish carry top laner playstyle instead of a Shen helping your team playstyle. At this point, my last hitting was also getting very good. Fiora has so many tools for reaching perfect like 10 CS per minute, because he has so auto attack resets, she has Q, and just it makes farming really easy on her. Now, as you can see here, I actually managed to win the Aatrox matchup, which was so difficult for me on my first day. And that game, I actually ended up going something like 8-2-6 with a Manamune build. I hope you enjoyed this video. It was definitely a test for me because it's a newer style of making videos. But if you want to see more of this in the future, you should recommend a champion for me to play. So just leave a comment in the comment section below stating what champion do you want to see me play next for 7 days, and I will make a similar video if this video gets a good reception from you guys. In summary, I had a lot of fun playing a new champion that I was not comfortable on, and I feel like League of Legends as a whole, the game revolves around having so many different champions. It's fun that you can learn new stuff, and I think I will continue to hone this like style of learning new champions and making videos about them, because I honestly had a lot of fun doing this challenge. I hope you guys enjoyed, and if you're new to the channel, consider subscribing. It's free, and I don't see a reason for you guys not to. See you guys later. Thanks for watching.